Just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are on the field, and we're just about ready to open things up.
Roberts back to return.
He'll return it from the one. Gets out to about the 21.
Kickoff returns 20 yards.
The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive. They'll spread the field with five wide. Caught over the middle. He's out to the 30. He's taken down at about the 33-yard line.
I'm really liking what I see from this guy. He's not afraid to go to the air on any down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 33. Quick strike to the receiver. And he's taken down at the 47. And a nice pickup there.
I'll tell you what, the defense gambled a bit here and came with the blitz. And the quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
From the 47-yard line, first down. Out of bounds at the 45.
Called a gain of 2 yards. That brings up second and 9.
Tight left, tight left. Four down.
Mike check, 33.
Ready.
Check, check,
check, check.
Just throws this one away. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 37. Around the 37-yard line.
It was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
And down he goes at about the 27-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27. Play. Gets out to around the 18.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards.
That brings and this play is number 8 on the drive.
Four down.
Mike check, 33.
Ready. Hit high. 18. Hit high. Red 18.
Run.
They're going to pitch it. Nice run to the outside. That play's good for about 6 yards and a first down.
Pretty good run here. The tailback got the ball on the pitch out and did a nice job of following his blocker. Was able to pick up the first down.
First and 10. Ball on the 12. Tackle at the 10. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it 2nd and 8.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Four down.
Mike check, 33.
Nice run, and he's brought down.
Gain of 5 on the play. Third down.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about 4. A man open touchdown. And a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And he adds the extra point. So an 11-play, 80-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown. So our score, 7-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. And now he's got room to run. And they make the stop around the 41-yard line. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
He's tackled around the 40-yard line.
Good discipline here by the defense, stringing the option out and plugging the running lanes. That moved him back.
Got it complete. He's out of bounds.
A quarterback's best friend is a receiver he can count on to catch the ball every time he drops back the pass.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and 5.
Hey, tighten down. There you go.
Fires to his receiver, first down. And he's tackled right around the 28-yard line.
On the tackle at the 28-yard line.
First down.
Big opening. He kept it himself and picked up a good-looking first down.
Great execution and a good decision there by the quarterback.
From the 17-yard line, it's first down. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
That was a loss of 4 yards.
Here's the 8th play of the series. Up the middle for a nice gain.
That's a gain of 4 on the play. That brings up 3rd and 10.
They come out on an empty backfield. Levels at the 24-yard line.
That's a loss of 7 yards. Fourth down.
After the sack, it's now 4th and long. The kick is up, and he missed it left. No good. And here comes the offense again. They'll try to make it 2 touchdowns and 2 possessions.
You know, this offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receivers. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
It's 1st and 10. Ball on the 39. Western Michigan is up a score. He throws left, makes the grab, and steps out right away. Bring him down around the 43-yard line.
3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Second and 7. Ball on the 43. They'll work the left. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
No gain. That makes it 37.
Check. Tight right. Full out there. Check it out. Up there. Four down. Mike check 33.
Ready. Hot.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Steps out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
That makes it
fourth down. They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Kicks up, and it's wide right. No good. We're through one quarter. The Broncos with a touchdown lead. And we welcome you back to the action here. Just about set to start the second quarter.
With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. Brought down in the open field.
16 yards. First down.
They come out in a five wide set. After a decent run up the gut.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Mike 40. Easy.
Wears it out to the right to the halfback. Tackle made right around the 40. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Good open field tackle.
That's good for a game of 16 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Five wide. Makes it to the 11.
Game of 13 on the play.
Too easy.
First down.
And they'll get him in the backfield. Hopefully he's going to be okay.
That'll bring up second down 11.
Second down and 11 yards to the sticks. Ball on the 12-yard line.
Green nine.
And he tackles him hard at the 14-yard line.
That is a loss of 2 yards. That'll make it third and 13.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Got it and brought down immediately.
Number 3 on the tackle at the 7-yard line.
This should be an easy field goal.
And six.
It's up, and it is good.
Even though they gave up a field goal here, that defense is feeling pretty good about themselves right now. It could have just as easily been a touchdown.
Lopez looks ready to kick this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20, and he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Western Michigan holds a 4-point lead. And he throws it away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Caught, open field. He's out of bounds at the 26. From their own 26-yard line, third down.
Run!
throws, and it's incomplete.
Boy, that hurts the offense to have to go three and out. They're going to have to think about how to get something going the next time they come out.
Tucker is the deep man awaiting the return. Tackle at the 44-yard line.
Return for a gain of 11 yards.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Pass complete and taken down immediately. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Three down.
Hey, go, Mike 40.
Green nine.
That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line. Knock him down for a loss.
That brings up fourth and three.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. And this is what power football is all about, folks. Toss. He didn't get it. It's not even close. And the defense comes through.
Yeah, they went with a toss play here, but no one on that defensive side of the ball was fooled. You got to give them credit for making a great play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Western Michigan is up by four. Here's the give. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. The defense was all over that draw play.
And they got very good containment on the halfback. He had nowhere to go with the football.
It's second and 12. Ball on the 46. He's under pressure. Throws incomplete.
This wide receiver is very frustrated. You can tell by his body language. He did everything he needed to do to get open to be able to make a big play. The quarterback just didn't put the ball in the money.
The Blue Raiders saw one of their key guys go down earlier, but it looks like he might be able to get back in the action. Got his receiver, dropped it, incomplete.
Davis was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it fourth and 12.
Schrader awaits the snap. And here's the... Wait a minute, the upback's got it. What a collision. The defense forced a turnover on downs on the last drive.
Well, this offense is going to have to do a better job on this drive. Remember the last time, they went for it on fourth down and came up short. Now they get the football back. Let's see how they can do.
Got it, but knocked out of bounds for a short loss.
That brings up second and 13.
Second down, 13 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Quick pass, brought down at the 40.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That'll bring up 32.
Mike 40.
He goes out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. From the 37-yard line, first down. Slings it, and he's taken down at the 31-yard line.
Number 24 with the tackle at the 31-yard line. That'll make it second and four.
Easy.
Motion.
Let's it go. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. put his defense in alignment and a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. They're going to try a long field goal here. Kick is away. It's long enough, and he just drilled it from long range.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
7-6, Western Michigan. Lopez ready to kick. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback.
Well, really a defensive battle going on right now so far, Kirk.
Well, the defenses are flying around the football, doing a good job. I think both offenses are making it a little easier because of their style game plan. I think if I were the offensive coordinator, I'd take a few chances. Be willing to open it up and try to give your quarterback a chance to make a play.
Western Michigan with a one-point lead. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's taken down around the 46-yard line.
That's the kind of play calling and execution I like to see. Being one-dimensional on first down can really stack the odds against you. It's better to mix it up.
Boy, was he drilled as he let go of that football.
Yeah, he's going to feel that one tomorrow.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line. Rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Tucker back deep to return. Here's the punt. No, they're going to throw it. Can't find his man, and they'll turn it over.
Unable to pick up the first down, and the ball will change hands.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. There's a strike complete. And he is drilled at the 48-yard line. The Blue Raiders taking their first time out of the half. From the 48-yard line, second down. Caught out of the open. Middle Tennessee State will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. Frazier picks up about 5 yards on that hookup. He gets it up. No good. He pushed it to the right. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Western Michigan is up one. He chucks it downfield. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete. Great game in the works, folks, as we come to the end of the first half. The Broncos lead it by one.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here, completely locked in on that first half. The stats are certainly not overwhelming from an offensive standpoint. These two teams averaging less than 6 yards per pass attempt. That's not really what you're after in the passing game. But a lot of it can be attributed to really good defense. You know quarterbacks want to take care of the ball first, but they also want to push it down the field. How do you balance that with this guy Not a lot of room downfield to throw the ball, it doesn't seem, but he's taking the check down pretty quick.
Yeah, well, and if there is no room down the field, and you don't see very many open receivers just streaking. I mean, you haven't seen that. So the defense is doing a good job of taking that deep stuff away. But the number one thing is, if you're going to bail out Reese and you give him that underneath stuff, that easy pass completion, you got to tackle. And that's what they're doing. They're coming up and they're not letting him, you know, throw a 7-yard route that goes 50 yards. And that's one of the biggest keys to defense. Let him throw the underneath stuff, come up, make a good tackle, live to fight another down.
You know, I had a wise coach once tell me, teams do not beat you throwing and catching. They beat you by running after the catch.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 25. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking, if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Gets it out, and he's met immediately. From their own 18-yard line, second down. They make the stop at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
Green nine. Tackle at about the 47-yard line.
I love the blitz, but the quarterback did a really good job of seeing it and reading it, and then standing tall in the pocket to find his man for the first.
He's on the run. They bring him down.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
Mike 40, check. He's coming. Green nine.
Blue 4.
He's going to try and scramble, and he's going to be sacked for a loss. So the sack makes this third and very long. And he'll be sacked again. These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. He really got a hold of that one. And he's taken down at the 33-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Western Michigan, up a point. He's under some heat. Throws it to the outside. And it's incomplete.
Perfect timing to jar the ball loose and not pick up the penalty. That was a solid play.
That makes it second and
from 10. Their own 33-yard line. It's second down. Hit as he threw, and he completes it. He steps out at the 50-yard line.
midfield. First down. Pass, man open, and he dropped it.
Number 89, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Three down.
Hey, check my 33.
Red 18.
Red 18.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
Call him a loss of 8 yards on the play.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. Here's a quick throw. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. Western Michigan with a 1-point lead. Fires incomplete to the fullback.
Number 47 was the intended receiver on the
from the 37-yard line. Second down. And he's tackled at about the 27-yard line. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Steps out of bounds at the 24. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. Feeds it to the back, and they hit him in the backfield.
A good tackling safety is key for any defense, and if they can diagnose a play like this guy can, he can be a real menace.
Here's play number 10 on the drive. Under pressure, loose football. The defense scoops it. Good hustle there by the D lineman.
It's often an overused term when referring to defensive linemen, but that's what they mean when they talk about a guy has a motor that's running. He never quit, and he played to the whistle.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
That makes it second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 33. He's tackled at the 42. Here he goes. Makes it out to about the 46.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't run out. They don't run out of this.
First down.
He throws right. Got him again. And he will score.
This guy just continues to impress me. Every time I watch this team play, he seems to come up with big plays.
They'll go for two in this situation. They don't get it.
A defensive end with this kind of speed is an offense's worst nightmare. He's got the ability to collapse the pocket on any given pass play. And as a play caller, you constantly have to be aware of him. Whether you're going to roll away from him or you're going to chip with a tight end or a running back, you're constantly concerned and aware of a big, strong defensive end.
Middle Tennessee State kicked this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23-yard line. The Blue Raiders continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Throws into coverage, just picked off. Tackle made at about the 19-yard line. Spectacular play there by the linebacker to come away with that interception.
I don't even think the quarterback saw him on that play. He was right there waiting for the ball.
First and 10, ball on the 19-yard line. And down he goes around the 9-yard line.
First and goal.
Green nine, easy, easy.
They'll bring him down at the 3-yard line.
That's a gain of six on the play. That brings up second and goal.
Now he tries to buy some time. Room around the corner. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. They weren't able to defend the quarterback scramble, and they give up six.
And he's one of those quarterbacks who can do this when he's close to the goal line. He'll pump fake, then take off, or he'll put his head down and crash it in. Anything goes with this guy.
And he adds the extra point. A short three-play, 19-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So the score now, 19-7. Excellent kick. He's taken down at the 25-yard line. Well, let's see if he can shake off that pick that he tossed last time out.
Anytime you give the ball away, it's a disappointment. So these guys want to show that they can hang on to it.
Throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
And he's taken down at the 33.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That'll bring up third and 2.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Down at the 36-yard line. Good run there.
Well, given assist there to the offensive line, they gave him a good push up front.
Fires out to his wideout. He's taken down around the 47-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 47-yard line. Throws this one out to the right. He gets another, and this is a big one. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. And the big pickup through the air has made it first and goal. Don't leave yet, folks. We still got one more quarter to go. 19-7. Middle Tennessee State. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Let's go, D.
Hey, check my 33. Check my 33.
Ready!
He gets rid of this one.
Check four.
It's second and goal. Ball on the 8. They'll spread the field with 5 wide. The cavalry's coming. They'll make the sack.
That makes it third and goal.
And this is the 8th play of the drive.
Four down. Mike, check 33. 33.
Quick toss. In the air. It's intercepted.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
From their own 20-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. He delivers, and he went way up, and he's got the interception.
I really liked his corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Back to his fullback, but he can't hang on.
Number 47, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Down.
Mark, check 33.
He wants it all. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Phillips, the intended receiver on the play.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31.
Tight end, right. Four down. Hey, check my 33.
Red 18.
Going deep, lays it out there.
You know, I know it's late in the game, but you never want to give up big plays, let alone in a two-possession game. You give up a score, and next thing you know, it's only one possession, and this team has a shot to tie the game up.
It's first and goal, and they'd love to get into the end zone and make this a game again. This defense has been in this situation before. They forced a huge turnover when they were backed into their own red zone last time. Throwing left. It falls incomplete.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception, and what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
And he makes it out to about the 8-yard line. Franklin picks up a yard on the play.
That makes it third and goal.
The defense has really held their own the last two plays. Now it's third and goal from the 7. Swings it out there incomplete.
Well, that was clearly a poor read on somebody's part. And the bad news is there was no defender around. If the pass was anywhere near him, it could have gone for a big play.
He's in trouble. And they make the stop
around the 3-yard line.
Here's a step in the maturation of a young quarterback. How does he respond to throwing an interception on that last drive?
And we'll see how aggressive this defense is when they come back out.
I would be surprised if they kept up the pressure to try to fluster this quarterback some more.
He makes it to the 6-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it 2nd and 7.
Good outside run there. He's to the 20. And he hits him hard at the 25. And the tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back.
Give to the tailback. Tackle right around the 24-yard line.
That is a loss of 1 yard on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
Flips it middle to the running back. They'll wrestle him down in the backfield.
Number 15 takes him down behind the line at the 24-yard line.
So we're looking at another 3rd down here. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. At the 34-yard line.
That's a gain of 10 on the play. 4th down.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the 4th quarter. He makes it to the 38-yard line. They're set to go for another round. Throws it deep. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Phillips, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it 2nd and 10.
2nd down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 38. He airs it out. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
3rd on the coverage. 3rd down.
Can't tack on any yardage. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start, offense.
It's so tough to move the ball forward. Even a 5-yard setback can do damage to a drive.
So a 4th down stop there late in the 4th quarter, and that should do it. And they're going to have to give the ball back after going for it on 4th and long.
Not much you can do there. You got to go for it and give yourselves a chance.
It's a new possession for this offense, so what will it hold? A little over a minute in the game. Gets out to around the 28.
Now he took the pitch there and was able to get the 1st down. It's a nice option play.
from the 28-yard line. It's first down, five wide. Handoff on the draw. Gets to about the 27-yard line. The Broncos use their second timeout. Gets out to around the 18. Great job on the running back, and that's a gain of 9. Western Michigan will take their final timeout. He makes it to the 15-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee. And the ball game's over. The Blue Raiders take the win, 19-7.
Blue Raiders, 19, and the Broncos.
So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.